We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order, a world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order.
Mondex is a corporation that is probably going to be one of the one of the key players in the end times here toward the mark of the beast. This is the final stage in becoming a global reality, said Robin Kelly of Mondex International. With MasterCard's backing, there's nothing to stop Mondex now from becoming the global standard. You need to keep an eye open for smart cards. They are coming next. You guys in the military already have a Mark card, which has an enormous amount of information in there. It's a little computer circuit built right into a card. You got yours with you? You got to have it with you, right? Steve, you got yours? That little Mark card. The next step is very simple. It becomes a little microchip, and it's injected in the right hand. I met last night, I was in Little Rock, Arkansas, and I met with, this morning I was in Little Rock, but I met with Carl Sanders. Carl Sanders has been a friend of mine for years. He is one of the guys who helped invent the little microchip. And he travels all over and speaks on this topic. He's a Christian and shows people, look folks, we are very close to the coming of the Lord. You know, 20 years ago, the prophecy that everybody would receive a mark in their hand or in their forehead before you could buy or sell, 20 years ago, that was a... People laughed at that prophecy. Yeah, right. How are you going to get a mark to buy or sell? And Carl Sanders has a lot of information how the Greek word for mark is etching. And microchips are etched in the silicone. And he goes through a whole series of how it fits exactly what the book of Revelation says is going to happen. Some type of little chip is probably what's going to be the mark of the beast. And it's going to be in the right hand or the forehead. Anyway, smart cards are here. Set technology means secure electronic transaction. Everybody that uses their credit card, of course, wants to make sure, is this secure? Are you going to give my credit card number to other people so they can charge stuff? You know, it's assumed that the card is secure. It's called Set technology. It's interesting they chose that name because Set is the Egyptian god of evil, or Satan. It's just a coincidence, I'm sure, but AT&T Lucent Technologies purchased the franchise from Mondex USA. Their logo is the symbol of the solar serpent, the red dragon, which is Lucifer. Satan does have plans for a one-world government, and you have to control the money.
Illuminized Masonic symbolism is all over America. On the back of the dollar bill on the left-hand side above the pyramid, it says Anuit Coeptus, which means our enterprise is now a success, or a crowned success. So what enterprise does it mean? Well, Novus Ordo Seclorum near the bottom. Novus meaning new, Ordo is order. Seclorum is where we get our word secular, meaning the world. So it means new order of the world, simply new world order. So what it's saying is the new world order is now a crowned success. This was put on the dollar bill in 1934. 1934 is when the Federal Reserve took total control of the United States monetary system. The Fed is essentially controlled by two Illuminati bloodlines, the Rothschilds and the Rockefellers. President Franklin D. Roosevelt, a 32nd degree Scottish Rite Mason, placed the seal on the dollar bill. Roosevelt was also in the Order of the Nobles of the Mystic Shrine, known for its satanic rituals. The pyramid has 13 steps. In fact, the number 13 is on the bill everywhere. 13 leaves on the olive branch. 13 berries. 13 stripes on the shield. 13 arrows. 13 stars. 13 letters on E Pluribus Unum. And 13 letters in Anuit Coeptus. Now some people believe 13 is on the bill due to the 13 colonies, but dig a little bit deeper and you'll find the real answer. The 13 colony explanation is subliminal indirect reverse psychological propaganda. That's how these people do things. We must go back to the first occurrence of the number 13 in order to discover its key significance. It occurs first in Genesis 14 verse 4. It says 12 years they served Chedorlaomer, and in the 13th year they rebelled. These people are rebelling against the divine natural order, and Adam Weishaupt was a rebel as well. The other half of the meaning comes from Fritz Springmeier. 13 also represents the 13 top Illuminati families that he traced back to the late 18th century and the early 19th century. He is credible, and that's why he was framed by the government and thrown in a cage. 1776 is in Roman numerals near the bottom. Some think it's because of the founding of the country. Another case of subliminal indirect reverse psychological propaganda. 1776 is when the Illuminati was formed. The New World Order. Another striking fact is that the eagle has 32 feathers on the right wing, the number of ordinary degrees of the Scottish Rite. There's 33 feathers on the left wing, representing the 33rd degree. The tail has 9 feathers, which represents the 9th degree of the York Rite. The eagle itself is a prominent icon in masonry, extensively used in the Scottish Rite. Joseph Willard, president of Harvard in 1812, said, quote, "There is sufficient evidence that a number of societies of the Illuminati have been established in this land. They are doubtless trying to secretly undermine all our ancient institutions, civil and sacred. The enemies of all order are seeking our ruin. Should they prevail, our independence would fall, of course. A republican government would be annihilated." February 22, 1946, Grandmaster Truman went to the American United Lodge and took an oath to govern the country on Masonic principles. He said, quote, "My work is built on Masonic principles. I believe that these leadership principles must be spread all over the world," unquote. So how did Master Truman then spread his Masonic principles? He committed ritual mass murder on Japan when in 1945 he gave the order to annihilate hundreds of thousands of innocent people, vaporizing Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the only Christian city in Japan. The Grove is a 2,700-acre secluded area in the woods of Montreal, California. The fact is, there is irrefutable evidence that satanic ritual goes on inside the Bohemian Grove. Here is a photo of Masonic coffin ritual being performed in front of a shrine of the devil. Now, a documentary filmmaker and radio talk show host from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones, snuck into the Bohemian Grove in the year 2000 and filmed this satanic ritual known as the Cremation of Care. Notice the 50-foot stone idol. Notice the red, black, and white robes. Notice the fire and the satanic sacrifice. Now, either way, Moloch or Minerva worship is satanic. They both have child sacrifice. They're wearing black, red, and white cloaks and practicing idol worship. This Minerva is Satan in disguise. The owl at the Grove is further proof that the Illuminati lives on, since Vicep adopted the symbol of the owl from ancient Greece.
I am a happy member of the Bohemian Grove. I like the folks who come there, and it's really inappropriate for me to talk about the group beyond that. Thank you.
Have you been there for the ceremony with the cremation of care?
Frankly, I don't think that's something I need to talk to you about. You have this is what's called ambush journalism, and I disrespect you for that as well. So thank you and goodbye.
Have you ever been in the ritual?
It's none of your damn business.
Many people who attend the Bohemian Grove are on the news every day, leading double lives. Some of these people include George W. Bush.